have and kind of done a little bit of research. I like to learn about my guests.
Absolutely.
You know, everything that I saw from you, really just just down to earth, humility.
Yeah.
You know, like
absolutely.
And I think that's, you know, it's commendable. And and a real indication of that is admitting with the fake jewelry.
For sure. So the reason, you know, everybody asks me, why are you so transparent? Why are you so vulnerable and shit like that? And I'm just like, if I would have had the information beforehand, I would have done better in my career. I would have been bigger. I would never would have gone broke. I would have never done anything. But everybody before me that I had to look up to, they were just like, no, this is great. Once you start rapping, it's gonna just money all the time. Nothing's ever gonna happen bad. Nothing bad's ever gonna happen. Your family's not gonna come after you. Nothing's gonna happen. It's just rap, and it's just girls and swimming pools after this.
So about that, and power to you for just offering it up. You know, a lot of people wouldn't admit to going broke.
After I went through that whole episode, I found out if I would have known that other artists have gone through this, people I look up to, if they would have just said that, look, it's not all great. It's not gonna be fine this whole time. If I would have known that, I would have been mentally prepared. First of all, I would have been ready. I would have prepared myself financially. I would have put something aside. But you know, from the people that came before me, even rock stars, rappers, singers, everybody, athletes, just like, no, this whole thing is just money all the time. Right. You're good at something, it's just gonna be money. Always. Nobody's ever been like, so this goes away after a while. and nobody's ever offered that. And I feel like I have a responsibility and a service to the people that are coming after me to like, guys, remember how great I was? That shit goes away after a while. And here's the things that happen to show you the patterns that it might be coming. It might be coming. Here's how you know you're running out of money. Here's how when you call your fucking when you call your finance team and they're like, you may not want to grab this fourth house.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Okay, when you start hearing shit like that, maybe. Right. Maybe stop buying jewelry.
let's not look at a Bugatti.
Exactly. Let's not look at a Bugatti. I bought my Bugatti. And it was fine. I was fine. And you bought
it for $2.1 million.
$2.1 million.
And then you, very shortly thereafter, you found out that you were actually broke, and you sold it for all they gave you was $800,000.
Yeah.
So it was like renting a car for $1.3 million.
Yeah. Renting a fucking car, and then I was like, hey, since I got this Bugatti, you know, I need another house. I can probably take this one. These people just moved out of a house that's literally connected to my house. So, you know, we can just walk a path, and there's like, you don't have any more money. And I was like, oh, I'm sorry, what? Say it again.
Right.
No. It was like, yeah, you don't have any more money. And I was like, how did you let that happen? And they were like, well.
Right.
How did you let that
happen? Right. All too often, it's actually a case where the management, the business manager, all the, you know, the people are actually stealing. But that wasn't the case with
that
you.
Wasn't the case with
this
me.
Was
that
just...
wasn't the case. I mean, it was a combination of it, actually, though.
Okay.
Yeah, so it was, you know, they were having fun with funds, but still not saying when it was running out.
Right.
Because they knew if I would have known that I was running out, I would have stopped making it.
The party's over.
Right. For everybody.
Oh,
for
shit.
Everybody.
Yeah,
wow. So don't let him know that he doesn't have any money, because if he stops trying to make money, we're not gonna get it.
They're like calling you like, when are you gonna make another album?
Right.
And you're like, I don't know why, I just did.
But to be fair, I did see in an interview you said that it was your choice not to even have access to your bank accounts to ever know what was in them.
Yeah, I didn't want to know. Because I didn't want to know because I was led to believe that this is just gonna, it's only gonna grow. Like, right. Why would I, why does, like, right. What am I gonna check in on how much more money I have? Because these rappers told me that I'm just gonna make money forever. So nobody runs out of money apparently. So fuck, do I need to check in for? It's just gonna keep going up and up.
Okay. Like,
fucking crazy.
So the peak for you would have been 2007 when you were on three like bona fide number one hits.
Absolutely.
One of which is Diamond Platinum.
Yes.
10 million sales.
Absolutely.
That's the Flo Rida Low song.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so you, in 2007, you're on top of the world.
On top of the world.
And it's never going to stop.
Yeah, like why the fuck would I check it?
Right.
Yeah.
If he's not checking rude it, to check.
It's
yeah.
Rude.
He's not waking up looking at his B of A with his coffee in the morning like.
Right. It's just fucking the Minority Report screen in front of me. I'm just like, yeah, that's another million.
Hey,
but then after 2007, I mean, from what you're saying, it just kind of cooled off, right? Like,
right. So what? My whole business model at that time was, you know. It's all going to be downhill. Everybody's like, it's downhill from here. But downhill in an easy way. So the analogy was, if you pedal up the hill, you can coast afterwards.
Right, okay.
And you can stop working.
That's so funny because in our world of recovery, like we're sober guys, yeah. You know, they talk about the work that you do in recovery. And
yeah.
They say you can only coast in one direction, and that's downhill.
That's funny. Which
is... absolutely the opposite.
Right. No, meaning you don't want to coach.
Yeah. So you don't want to coach. So you have to keep working. Yeah. What they don't tell you is that you coast. Totally fine. You coast. There's another hill. Mm-hmm. So, you gotta keep going. But I was telling my wife, like it got so bad, I didn't live with my wife. Like for like 3 years. And I was, because I was like, if you live with me, I'm not going to be able to pay attention to my career.
Oh.
And I was like, you got to live in a different house, everything. And it was so crazy. It was
how much
just,
of that was a smokescreen for like.
All just, of it. All of it.
Right.
All of it was just like, I can't be held. You know what I'm saying? It was,
right.
You know what I mean? It was just like. There's no way for me to maintain this lifestyle. There's no way for me to, you know, I always tell people the hardest thing about being number one is staying number one.
Sure.
So I was so upheld with that. I was just like, nothing else can come into my life right now.
Right.
And I was already married for fucking 4 years. And I was just like, you gotta stay in a different city. And I can't.
So it started out different house and then it had to be different
right.
city.
Just whole thing. So I was just like. Okay, nobody can talk to me. Nobody talk to me. I need to stay number one. Nothing needs to fuck with me right now. And then turns out it was me that was fucking with me.
Can I just tell you how fucked up my new tour is? It's completely multimedia, legitimately X-rated. There's legal waivers all over the venue because I'm actually worried about getting sued. And I don't give a fuck, man, because it's gnarly and it's all the stuff I wasn't allowed to do on Jackass. So get to my fucking website, stevo.com, and get your tickets, man. Especially with this movie coming out, dude. They're all gonna sell, dude, so hurry up while you can get seats. Yee-hee!